The Pallisers, dramatised by Mike Harris, based on the novels by Anthony Trollope.
This story begins properly 15 years before I died, in the 1860s, when everything was completely different. Young women were denied power, but sought it anyway. Very rich men dominated the cabinet. The people were bitterly disaffected, and a general election had just given us a divided government with a tiny majority. Oh yes, and of course, politicians were ambitious, chased young women, and often abused the power they had over them. So, let me begin with introductions.
Where the hell is it? That burger, you are a complete bastard.
This is Phineas Finn, our hero of sorts. 25 years old, good-looking, average height, average abilities, and, well, average in every way, if we don't count his remarkable ability to be agreeable.
Oh, Burgo, thank God you're back. Have you stolen my best cravat again?
Not on this occasion, Phineas.
And the breathless gentleman who has just rushed in with his travelling valise is Burgo Fitzgerald. 29, 6 foot, saturnine, handsome, wild, dangerous. Broke. Everything young girls should avoid like the plague. Burgo has dashed to the window to see if he's given his pursuer the slip.
Glory be.
For what?
Moneylenders who aren't fit. So, how is the newly elected MP for much piddling?
It's puddling, and I'm late.
I assume you've heard already.
That you didn't get in, our landlord told me. Seems to know more about politics than I do.
Now shut the door, will you? I'm freezing. Your sympathy is deeply appreciated. After all, it only cost me £3,000 in bribes. Whiskey?
Behind you. I'd have more sympathy if you'd actually wanted to be an MP.
I did. Desperately.
Only because you thought it would impress Violet Standish.
Yeah, and therefore I'm devastated. Lost my chance of obtaining the hand of little Miss Politics.
Not to mention her money. Mm.
I am not mercenary, Finn. Merely disinherited by a wicked father, and therefore equally in need of cash and love.
Well, it's a real pity the great Lady Cora threw you over. Pass me those trousers.
It is. But hope springs eternal in that direction.
What? She's married, man.
Yeah, catch. Where are you off to, anyway?
Sir Robert Kennedy's grand victory dinner.
And how did an impoverished paddy like you manage an invitation to that?
Violet has clout with Kennedy.
Would you leap into my grave as quick?
Do I hear growling in the manger?
Touché. But I'm not a blue bottle. I eventually know when a window's closed. The field is yours. And she's got a cool £1,000 a year.
What were you saying about not being mercenary?
Rather you than Kennedy.
Meaning?
He's got his gimlet eye on her, and Violet, bless her, has an eye for power, so you have no time to lose. Couldn't lend me a fiver, could you?
What for?
Unforeseen expenses.
Nope.
A quid.
A crown. Here. Don't spend it all at once.
Thank you, sir.
Now I'll have to walk home.
Mr. Burgo?
Yes, Mr. Bontz?
Is Mr. Grimes at the front door?
God's teeth, I thought I'd given him the slip. Keep him there, will you, Bontz? There's a good chap. Quick, sign this.
What is it?
Just a bond.
What sort of bond?
Oh, you pretend to promise to pay off Grimes in 3 months, by which time I'll be able to do it myself. Yeah.
Burgo, I'm in debt too.
But he's threatening me with debtor's prison.
And MPs aren't paid.
But they do have legal immunity, so even if I do welch, he can't touch you, can he? So, pretty please?
I know I'm going to regret this.
Oh, Vergara, you're a bug, Tuttengadzu.
What are you doing?
Climbing out of the window.
Why?
In case Grimes has acquired any more of my debts, and also now that Violet has denied me thrice.
What?
Plan B, dear boy. Doodle-pip!
Come with me now to the Liberal Party's grand victory reception and dinner, where we shall meet the other leading players in the drama that is about to unfold.
Congratulations on your promotion, Robert.
This is Lady Violet Standish, of whom Finn and Burgo were just speaking. 28-year-old heiress of independent means, with an unusual interest in public affairs.
Without a majority in Parliament, Violet, I can't see myself being in the job for very long.
Sir Robert Kennedy, MP, Home Secretary in our newly elected Liberal government.
But if we keep our radicals on board.
In exchange for electoral reform? No, thank you.
Surely that would be a good thing, Sir Robert? No taxation without representation and all that?
And who are you?
This is Phineas Finn, newly elected MP for much piddling.
Puddling.
You sound like a radical, sir. Hello, Kennedy. There's going to have to be some electoral reform, whether we like it or not.
And that was my husband Plantagenet. Planty for short. The Right Honourable Plantagenet Palliser MP for long.
Who says? PM, send me a note. I'm to be Leader of the House, charged with getting something through.
What on earth is Gresham thinking of?
We can speculate over food, gentlemen. Shall we go in?
And while they're doing that, I can brief you further. Palliser is, or should I say, was, my husband. I'd been married off to him the year before when family discovered my secret engagement to Burgo Fitzgerald.
I'm not sure I can stand five courses of politics every day of my married life, Violet. Cheers.
And this is yours truly, Lady Cora, as I was then, beautiful, blooming, barely 19, and already unhappily married.
Cheers. But politics is fascinating, Cora. To you, give it time. He tried to explain the British Constitution in bed last night. Call me frivolous, but I want something rather more.
But not Burgo Fitzgerald, I hope.
Well, he's obviously out of the question now. Besides, isn't he pursuing you again?
It was. I just turned him down again.
One of the few advantages of being untimely dead is the ability to go where you weren't allowed in life. So, let's go now with the gentlemen as they retire for brandy, cigars and billiards.
Well, we have to give some working men the vote, Kennedy.
Why?
Well, apart from the principle of the thing.
What principle?
Radicals like Finn here will vote with the Tories, put us out if we don't.
I'm not actually a radical.
Well, my group will vote with the Tories and put us out if you do, Palliser. I take it you still want tax cuts, though.
Which radicals like Finn will oppose.
I didn't precisely say I was
a... Unless we give them some reform in exchange, eh, Finn?
I really can't speak for it.
Mr. Finn.
Lady Cora?
Come outside.
What can I do for you, milady?
Cora, I need your help.
Of course, if I can. What sort of...
Help me save Violet.
Ah. Who or what do you think she needs saving from?
Kennedy's going to propose.
How do you know?
Have you seen how he looks at her? And Violet's related to everybody in liberal politics, so that would be useful to him.
But she'd say no, wouldn't she?
When we were children, she insisted on playing Parliament, but always had to be Prime Minister, which she can never be, of course. So pulling the strings of a man who might eventually be Prime Minister would be the next best thing.
I still don't see how I...
You're younger than him, more agreeable. She thinks you could rise quickly, and you find her attractive, don't you?
Is it that obvious?
And I know she finds you attractive.
That's not obvious.
She found you lodgings with Burgo, got you invited here, and she's helping you with your maiden speech tomorrow, isn't she?
How do you know that?
Well, she told me.
But...
What?
I'm already betrothed, in a manner of speaking.
To whom?
A young woman, in Ireland.
In a manner of speaking?
Both families expect it.
Then there isn't a problem. Engagements can be broken, as I know only too well.
This is kind of you, Violet.
Not really. We passed by your lodgings and I have a favour to ask in return.
Anything.
Tell Burgo to leave Cora alone.
Poor Finn. Not another emotional entanglement he has to sort out.
You want me to?
Yes.
You think he's still in love with her?
Burgo's in love with whatever he hasn't got.
But by that token, he should persist with you, shouldn't he?
Cora is more forbidden, and therefore currently more desirable.
May I ask why you turned him down?
Oh... Because I've known him since we were six and love him dearly, but he'd spend my fortune in a twinkling. And he has no real interest in politics. So will you speak to him?
I'm not sure my influence is so...
But you'll tell me if he looks like trying anything too insane.
Such as...
Good Lord, is that him?
Where?
Out there.
What's he doing?
That's Palliser's house. So I fear the worst. Stop the carriage!
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.